Are Marjorie Taylor Greene and Maxine Waters up there? Are they true representatives of the will of the people? Or do they just know how to get themselves elected into Congress? And that's the thing about a democracy. You get the government you deserve. And I think the same thing goes with drawing. If you don't practice enough, you end up getting crappy drawings like this one. This one didn't come out that good. The Maxine Waters one, I'm proud of that one. That's why I put that one up on the wall. That one I really liked. But this one didn't have a lot to work with, and her teeth looked like chiclets. But anyway, I'd really like to talk about the kind of people that we keep electing into Congress that end up affecting our very lives through the laws that they push through, and especially the inflation that we're feeling right now. It's not entirely a mystery why both of these passionate but pathological individuals managed to make it into Congress, because they represent the most extreme ends of the political spectrum between the need for liberalism and the need for conservatism. And most people have a hard time calibrating between a time and place to be liberal and when to be conservative. Now, in my quest for more understanding in life, I try to give people the benefit of the doubt. And in the case of Maxine Waters and her call for more violence when she went out of her way from her own district in California to join protesters all the way in Minneapolis, Minnesota, just days before the verdict of Derek Chauvin's trial over the killing of George Floyd, I'm trying to give Maxine Waters the benefit of a doubt that I'll never understand. I'll never understand what it's like to be a Black American female born in 1938, about 30 years before the Civil Rights Movement, who saw undeniable systemic racism to the point of segregated schools, bathrooms, water fountains, and even segregated beaches. But it's dangerous to deny that things have changed for the better in the United States. She's been a congressional representative for decades, and it's definitely dangerous to call for violence under the guise of civil disobedience, especially considering close to 30 people died as a result of rioting and looting during 2020 over the death of George Floyd. And when one considers less than 20 unarmed Black Americans were killed by police in 2019, it really begs the question, why is Maxine Waters denying that more people died over a demonstrably false narrative about Black Americans being targeted for execution by racist police nowadays? Now, in terms of denying reality, that's where Marjorie Taylor Greene gives Maxine Waters a run for her money. This woman not only believed the QAnon conspiracy, but actually followed it quite closely. There are videos of her actually encouraging people to go down that rabbit hole. And she's not that young either. She's well into her 40s. And yet she also fell for a few other conspiracy theories that have long been debunked about 9/11, as well as the deep state and satanic pedophile cannibalistic orgies such as Pizzagate. And despite all of Marjorie Taylor Greene's lunacy, I actually agree with her on some very pivotal issues. For example, her push back against socialism in this country, as well as the need for our right to bear arms for our self-defense. Those two things are make or break issues in this country, and I have to agree with her on that. And yet, she believed in QAnon. So if I had to choose between her and Maxine Waters as my congressional representative, I would be really confused as to who to vote for. But clearly, these are not the only qualified candidates we have to choose from. Within Maxine Waters' district, there was this young, fresh new voice, Joe Collins, that I thought for sure would have beat her out of her long entrenched seat in Congress. A guy that actually lives in the district, unlike Maxine Waters, who supposedly doesn't. Look, we don't have to keep falling for these false choices between extreme liberals or extreme conservatives. We just have to do a better job of thinking things through and stop electing people like Maxine Waters and Marjorie Taylor Greene that know how to exploit our most vulnerable differences for their own selfish gain, not to mention the selfish gain of their donors. We can learn to see through the falsehoods and insane lies so many of these politicians shamelessly peddle. Maybe then we will earn a democracy we truly deserve. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And if you want to support this channel, please check out the links down below. And thanks for watching.